ready to prep sole it and get some color on. I bought all the color and clear and everything in, so I don't have to leave the booth. I want to get this as clean as possible. I don't want to have to do any more polishing than necessary.
Was already different to the boot lid and my color was better, so I'm not even going to blend this. I'm just going to put my color the whole way out. It's just solid color black, so no metallic. Yeah, smash it on. Two coats is going to be covered. Well, truth be told, one coat should have it covered. And same up here, like, my color was better to the bonnet than what's already on there. This side must have been painted, or actually it's probably the other panels that have been painted, but I don't know. Either way, the paintwork that's on here is terrible. It really hasn't lasted. And come to think of it, that's Mazda. That's just those Mazda finishes that is, they just put like half a coat of clear on them, send them out the door. And it's for that reason I would never buy a new Mazda. I'd buy one that looks like this, get it for a good price and give it a coat of paint, because I am a painter. But yeah, here in Australia we've got a very harsh sun, we've got a hole in the ozone layer, and yeah, it's not too kind to paint. It does eat into it. So this is a bumper that my new apprentice Alan prepped up for me, did a killer job. I was only saying to him yesterday, like, it has been years since I've had an apprentice that I can actually properly trust to prep a panel up. Anything other than a new panel. Like a brand new panel, easy, baby. Like I could teach a 10-year-old how to prep up a new panel. But you've got to get original panels like this. You've got to sand the whole thing properly, pick up the stone chips, make sure the primer's done properly. Look, it's not rocket science, that's the thing about it. It's like, it's really not that hard. It's like a lot of these kids, they just don't want to spend the time and effort to actually learn a trade. I know not everyone, but just the people that I've been working with over the last sort of 5 or so years, it's like the young kids are actually getting worse. I mean, I think back to when I was an apprentice and stuff like that, and you know, if you wanted to get into a trade, you'd, most times people would actually want to learn that trade because they wanted to paint their car or they're enthusiastic about it. These days, it's, I don't know, it's all different. Seems like they just want a paycheck for doing stuff off, not even interested in the hard yards of the trade. Yeah, they might think, oh, that'll be great, I want to learn how to spray paint. They expect that they'll be in the booth spray painting in a couple of weeks, you know? It just doesn't work like that. And the truth is, like, painting is only really, like, probably 5% of this job, actually in the booth painting. The rest of it's all your press work. And if you can't get the rest of it right, well then I'm sorry, but you're not ready. It's as simple as that. Like, why would I let someone paint that can't prep properly? And I don't care if you're a fourth, fifth, or whatever year you are. I don't care if you've been doing it for 20 years. If you can't prep, well, sorry, you're not painting. Not in the shop that I'm in, anyway. Like this job here, it rocked up for primer at 11:30. It's probably only 2:30 now. So it wasn't even primed. I got it primed before lunch. I got the heat lights on it over lunch break. Came back after lunch, prepped it up, and we're in the booth ready to go. If I really wanted to prove a point, I could hit base, and it could be sitting in the bay ready for the boys to fit up first thing in the morning. There you go, covered in one coat. So just about, anyway. The second coat it'll be fully covered. That'll flash off in no time. Get a pic for the Instagrammers. Wet coat for that second coat. That's all it needs. Thank you. anyway. So I'll give that a few minutes between base and clear. I'm just going to stay in here, but I will flick the camera off. It's going to probably be about as enjoyable as watching paint dry.
So yeah, we'll come back in a couple of minutes once that base coat's flashed off.
So that's flashed off already. Ready to go with that clear coat here. Two bar, bam. 3.5, full fan. Hey, 20, 1.3 mil. The exact right amount of paint where you want it. Not too much, not too little. Exactly. Does exactly what I want. Hey, tweak your zone. You know, I've got nothing against you. You spray with a starter or a Sagola or whatever, but I've always been into velvet spray. It just feels right in my hand and it does what I want it to do. I don't even have this jacked up for speed. I don't want speed out of my gun. I don't want, it's not the only thing I look for, I should say. I don't want it too slow, but... So, some people, some starter sprayers, they're like, oh no, no, they're too slow for me. And I can understand that, like, if you're used to using a starter that's super fast, when you come to a developer, I'm not surprised that you don't like them. But it goes the other way around too. Like, I like the way the developer spray. I'm not really that surprised that I don't like the starters as much. Second coat on, and I want to let that flash off for a few minutes. This is going to be easily the best part on the car. Quickly, but I'll still give it a couple of minutes. Yeah, I don't like blowing air on my clear coat. I don't trust that. Don't mind blowing a bit of air over the base coat to dry it, but I never do it with the clear. Yeah, after being really, really busy for probably 3 or 4 weeks, slowly starting to get on top of it. So it feels like we are anyway from my end. It's been really tiring actually. taking its toll on me physically. Not so much mentally, I don't really care about it up in the head, but yeah. And just getting home late, early mornings and that. We got a bit of silicon on the quarter panel here. I'll be able to fill that up. A bit of a dab of clear and then we'll cut it back in the morning. Silicon there. So, that is pretty glassy and pretty clean. Not going to be much to polish in it.
That's the pass. Pretty happy with how it came up. Nice and glassy. One or two little bits of silicon here and there. A little ping-ding there we completely missed, but that was just a blend panel. Although I didn't blend it, it was actually just a blend panel. It wasn't... They didn't actually pay to have that panel repaired. And yeah, we just got those pinholes. That's exactly... That's what they are. We missed them. It happens sometimes, but I will be able to dab them in with clear, down the back in the morning and polish them. I won't actually have to repaint that panel or anything. Anyway, gotta go clean those guns out and jump onto the next job. See you in the next one. Gunman out. Actually, I'll show you guys my little dab trick. It's not gonna slow me down, but yeah, gonna have to stay in here for a minute anyway. I know some of the people like to watch those little extra things that I cut out. I guess that's what Gunman Roar is all about. Unedited. Painting as it happens in the real world. And you know, it's not all Instagram posts of off the gun finishes with perfect no orange peel and stuff like that. And you know, it's not, it's just simply not. It's the real world and shit happens. So you can do little touch-ups with a bit of tape rolled up or sometimes stuff like this. That should flow in a bit nicer. A little bit on this one too. It can be hard to judge depth when you're so close and with your glasses. Okay, that'll flow in nice too. Make sure there's no more. But yeah, that is actually really clean. I'm kind of a bit spewing about those two parts because honestly, apart from that, you barely even polish it. And not having to polish a job is, especially on a black, is a big bonus. So I reckon it's just do them and then this bumper, obviously. This is a bit of a pity, but it does happen. I can't even see it, man. I can't even see where I'm trying, it's just like a mirror. Depth perception is like totally screwed up when you're looking into something that glassy. Might even actually be best off touching them up in the morning. But I want them to be able to dry, that's the only downside of doing it that way. I want them to dry overnight. Lob it in there, come on. You can see I smashed that clear on too. So I knew about these and I wanted to fill as many of the small ones up. There was a few small ones over there. But yeah, these are, you know, these are things that will definitely polish out. They kind of look a bit nasty now, but they'll come up fine. Trust me, I'm a doctor. Like, this is silver, yeah, it'll look terrible. I wouldn't even be doing what I'm doing now. I wouldn't even attempt it. With the dark colours, not gonna see it in the colour. That's it, another one here. So today is the Wednesday before Easter, can't wait, 4-day holiday. Happy Easter everybody! Don't forget lots of Easter eggs. I mean, you're probably watching this a few weeks down the track at least. It does take time to get these vids up on YouTube, but yeah, that one's a little crater, that's like a deep crater, but I don't know if it's worth touching up. No, that's us. That's us. Alright there, Gunners. Have a good one, and I'll see you next time. Laying down that glass! Get out there and paint some shit!